Hi everyone, I'm Sebom. I hope you're all doing well. Today I'm going to be sharing three perceptual illusions that you may have come across before, and I'll also be teaching you the reasons behind why they are illusions to us. First up, we have these two lines. Which one of them seem longer? At first glance, you would be tempted to say the line on the top. But in fact, the two lines are exactly the same length. If we remove the arrows on the sides of the line, we can see that they're in fact the same length. This illusion occurs due to the different orientations of the arrows on the sides of the lines. The arrows pointing outwards make the line seem longer, and the arrows pointing inwards make the line seem shorter. On to our next illusion. In this photo, you'll see that the bar in the middle is a gradient going from a light gray color on the left side to a darker gray towards the right side. But this isn't true. The bar in the middle is actually the same gray color throughout. We perceive the gradient in the bar because our eyes interpret the colors and shades of objects depending on the shades and colors of the background as well. So a lighter background will make an object seem darker, and a darker background will make an object seem lighter, like we saw with this bar. Now, moving on to our final illusion. When you look at this photo, do you see a rabbit or a duck? Different people will have different responses. This is because when we encounter an ambiguous image or object like this one, we tend to interpret them by relying on our past experiences. We rely on our past experiences to make decisions every day, often without us even realizing. In this case, for example, whether you know it or not, you might be more familiar with information associated with ducks than rabbits, which can make it more likely for you to perceive this photo as a duck. But if you keep looking at the image, you'll realize that you're able to switch between seeing a duck and a rabbit. Now you might be wondering, Sebom, what does this all mean? First, I want to emphasize that everybody experiences these illusions because of the way our brains have been developed over time. But that said, you might have realized that if you spend a little more time on the photos and pick apart your initial perception, you were able to see past the illusions. Hopefully, this helped you realize that although our minds have this amazing ability to help us make quick decisions and make sense of the world around us, sometimes it's good to step back, slow it down, and evaluate what is in front of us, because things may not always be as they seem. I hope you enjoyed the three illusions I shared with you today. I hope you have a great week. And before I go, I'm going to leave you with this last illusion. Doesn't it seem like this photo is moving? Well, you might have guessed. It is in fact not moving.